which is this from the front page of WrestlingObserver.com. Janel Grant has agreed to pause her lawsuit against Vince McMahon, WWE, and John Laurinaitis. According to comments from Ann Callis, the attorney representing Grant, her client has agreed to a request by the U.S. Attorney's Office to stay her litigation pending a non-public investigation into the matter. Ms. Grant has consented to a request by the U.S. Attorney for the Southern District of New York to stay her case against Mr. McMahon, WWE, and John Laurinaitis, pursuant to a, quote, pending non-public investigation. We will cooperate with all appropriate steps. February, the Wall Street Journal, ABC News, reported the U.S. Attorney for the Southern District of New York had launched a criminal investigation into allegations of sexual misconduct, sex trafficking against McMahon. Dave wrote, basically, the Grant lawsuit is pausing at the request of the Justice Department as the government is conducting its own investigation. So essentially, a federal investigation into Vince McMahon trumps a civil suit. And so the civil suit is on pause while they do whatever it is they're going to do. What that means? Honestly, actually, nobody knows right now. And everybody thinks they know based on what they think about people, but we don't know anything right now. They might have something on Vince. They might not. It's an investigation. Hammer could fall. Might not fall. We will find out. But the stay is expected to last 6 months, a source close to the case stated to Bloomberg. So basically, within 6 months, we're going to find out if the feds have anything on Vince McMahon. And if so, if they bring charges, etc. So that's the update right now. That's a big change.
Yeah, as Deadline wrote today, a separate filing Thursday from Damian Williams' office made it pretty clear that the government is not just dipping its toe into these potential toxic waters. Obviously, they raided his phone. We had the report come out in February that they were looking into things, and it was just going to be a matter of time before we heard something, and today we have heard something. So it is another hurdle, certainly for Vince McMahon and his side right now, and this could be drawn out for quite some time, depending on what they're looking for, what they found, and what they're going to continue to do when it comes to the government. So, yeah, I mean, again, we're just going to have to wait and see what happens here. Things are probably going to start dribbling out over time. And I will say this, probably if they have anything on Vince, I think as the months go on, we're going to have some things leaked out, and we'll see where we stand. But this is, regardless of the civil suit, this is going to be all that stuff that Vince McMahon sold off. A lot of people were wondering, is he doing it because he wants to start his own company or this or that? It's a lot of it may just come down to legal fees because he may be in the mix for the rest of his life.
Well, I can say this. I can say this. Like, he sold billions and billions. I don't think he's going to have billions in legal fees.
No, he won't. But Bryan,
well, I can tell you this. Hold on. I got more.
Yes.
From people that have spoken to Vince, he does want to be involved in a business.
I'm sure he does.
And he has claimed to them that it's not the wrestling business. But I believe that one of the main reasons he sold all of that is he's got like some idea of something that he wants to do, which is the other reason, by the way, that he's going out of his way. It's not even the thing with Vince is he's not just trying to not lose his civil case or whatever, but he's very clearly trying to clear his name, which is why he keeps giving his side of the story, because he wants to do something in business. He wants people to work with him, and that ain't happening if he's got this this hanging over his head.
Well, I mean, but you also have to look at the fact that a lot of what's happening with this case is going to hinge on the NDA and does it stand up? Because he's got a lot of NDAs out there. And if it's for the same reasons or for some of the same reasons that, and we know that it is because he settled with Rita Chatterton, he settled with the tanning play. Those things can also, people can, if those are gone, people could also sue him again. you know, or go after him and actually sue him for the first time for something that he's done. So I understand that it's not going to be billions of dollars in legal fees, but depending on how this goes, Vince McMahon has also opened himself wide open for other cases to be brought against him. And also, even though it's not going to happen at this point, probably since it has not happened already, but if Linda McMahon decides, I'm divorcing you now, you know, again, then what does that mean? And I'm sure Linda's got her own money, but again, you know, to me, there's a lot of, I think, more than just wanting to run a business, there's a lot of trying to stuff money away because who knows how much he's going to be burning through.
So last night on Dynamite, they did the gauntlet match, which they call a gauntlet, even though it's not actually a gauntlet, but that's the casino gauntlet it is called. And the winner of the casino gauntlet is challenging Swerve at Forbidden Door. And the winner was Will Ospreay. So this opens, well, I got a lot of questions. So the first question is,
why did it take Swerve so long to be Kill Switch? Don't know.
No. I like that match a lot, actually. The first question that I've got is, okay, let's say that you want to make Will Ospreay champion. Well, if you want to make Will Ospreay champion, Wembley's in August. Why would you make him the champion at Forbidden Door when you could wait a mere 2 months and make him the champion at Wembley? Okay. Well, then you start thinking, as Dave said last night, well, maybe the idea is that Will loses at Forbidden Door, and then he goes on to face Swerve and beat him at Wembley. And the question that I asked was, well, first off, if Will is going to put somebody over to set up a challenger for after he becomes champion, then it should be someone other than the person he's going to beat for the title. But that's another story. So the other question is, okay, well, if he loses to Swerve at Forbidden Door, how do you justify him losing to Swerve but getting another match at Wembley? What do you do? And Dave said, well, it's easy. He wins the Owen Hart Cup. Okay, that's fine. But that begs this question. When is the Owen Hart Cup starting? Because the finals, we know when the finals are. Okay, the finals are July 10th. Forbidden Door is June 30th. So if you're not going to start the tournament until after Forbidden Door, then the entire tournament has to be done in 10 days, which is like 1 week of television. If you start the tournament prior to Forbidden Door, which is what I think they're going to do, then you have to explain why, if Will Ospreay is getting a shot at the title at Forbidden Door, he's also in a tournament to determine who gets a shot at the title at Wembley. So I haven't quite figured out what in the world is going on yet, but that appears to be how this all breaks down.
Do you think they have?
I hope so.
Do you think they have?
I think so. I mean, it's involving the world title, so I hope so. Funk Monk here says Ospreay won't be in the tournament. Well, if he's not in the tournament and he loses to Swerve, then he's not getting a shot at Swerve at Wembley. Is that what you want to do? Not have him go for the title at Wembley? Thank you for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel and click that notify button, and you'll never miss a video again.